Good morning. Today we are going to see the another application of IC555, that is monostable multivibrator. So last time we seen the stable multivibrator. Okay. So now we are going to see the monostable multivibrator. So this is the monostable multivibrator with internal block diagram. So just it is drawn here. The purpose is to just we know the working, how it works internally. Okay, so in exam just you have to draw this diagram. This is not compulsory. Okay, so you can draw this, okay, but this is not compulsory. This is compulsory diagram. Okay, so let us see here how it is connected. 6 number and 7 number pin is shorted. Okay, so resistor R1 is connected between VCC and short, and this capacitor C1 is connected between this and the ground. Okay, so this pin number 2 is triggered. So this is connected to the VCC through the resistor R, and there is a push switch, push to on type switch. Okay, it is grounded here now. Okay, so why we are using this trigger separately? Because in monostable, how monostable works, when we switch on this circuit, the monostable remains in a stable state. So this is stable state. When we apply a trigger, you have to apply a trigger means what? Just you have to press the switch and release. Okay, you just press the switch and release, and this output changes from low to high state. As output changes from low to high state, it remains some time. That this time is depends on the resistor R1 and capacitor C1 value. Okay, how much time it remains in this state, it depends on these R1 and C1. Okay, so after some time it returns automatically to the stable state. So it is stable state is low and high state is a quasi stable state. Okay, so this is the connection. You very well know the block diagram now. So this upper one is a non-inverting type comparator, lower one is a inverting comparator, because inverting input is connected to the changing voltage. So here non-inverting input is connected to the changing voltage, external voltage. Okay, so this voltage is compared with the stable 2/3 VCC. So this voltage is compared with the stable, that is 1/3 VCC, which is connected here. Okay, so upper one is the non-inverting, lower one is the inverting comparator. So this is the flip-flop and Q bar is the output. Okay, consider the initial state. When we switch on this circuit, what is the initial condition? The initial condition is output is in stable state. What is the stable state? Stable state is the output is low, zero. Okay, zero means Q bar is zero. Output is here Q bar. So here Q bar is equal to zero and Q is equal to one. So this is nothing but a state, set state. Okay, set state of the flip-flop. So Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0 is a set state of the flip-flop. And the next one is capacitor C1 is fully discharged. So here, why it is fully discharged? Let us see here. The Q bar is 0 and Q is equal to 1. So this is stable state. So here Q bar equal to 0 and Q is equal to 1. As Q is equal to 1, the transistor is goes into turn on. As transistor is turned on, this capacitor discharges through this transistor. So the capacitor discharges. So just when output is at low state, Q is at one high state, the transistor turn on and capacitor discharges through the transistor. So that initial state, in initial state, C1 is fully discharged through the transistor. Just write here, through the internal transistor. Okay, it is fully discharged through the internal transistor. Okay, so here another one is trigger voltage is at high, that is greater than 1/3 VCC. Okay, why trigger voltage is high? Because when switch is released, the pin number 2 is connected to VCC through the resistor R, that is high voltage. Okay, so let us plot here the initial condition. So initially output voltage is low, so here Q bar equal to 0. Okay, so that's why here output voltage is low. Capacitor is fully discharged, so this is the initial condition. Okay, so this is initial condition. Okay, so this is initial condition. The output is low, Q bar equal to 0. The capacitor voltage is 0. Okay, and the trigger voltage is high. So now you have to trigger the monostable multivalve. Trigger means what? You have to press the switch for a moment, very small time. For a moment you have to press the switch and then release. When you press the switch, what happens? When we press the switch, the pin number 2 is shorted through this switch. So here when we press the switch, the pin number 2 is shorted, means it is becomes equal to 0 potential, it is grounded. Okay, as it is grounded means it becomes less than 1/3 VCC, and when we release it, then again this voltage becomes high. But what happens at this position? When the triggered pin becomes less than 1/3 VCC, what happens at this position? Let us see here. Okay, just you have to see here, when you press the switch, this voltage becomes 0. As this voltage becomes 0, it is inverting, so output becomes 1, opposite. If it is 0, it becomes opposite, 1. Okay, so S equal to 0, because this capacitor is discharged, so this 0, it is a non-inverting, means output is 0, same. It is opposite, it is same. Okay, 0 volt, you will get 0, because it is non-inverting. Inverting means 0, it gets 1. So S0, R1. So this S0, R1 means the flip-flop goes into reset condition. When at this point, okay, so just at this point, when the trigger voltage becomes less than 1/3 VCC, flip-flop becomes reset. Okay, so flip-flop goes into reset condition. Reset condition means what? The Q bar becomes 1 now. So here Q bar becomes 1 and Q becomes equal to 0. It is a reset state of the flip-flop. Okay, and here it is, flip-flop is in set state. Okay, so sets mean Q bar equal to 0, Q equal to 1. So now it goes into reset condition, Q bar becomes 1, Q equal to 0. So now what happens? So because of this Q equal to 0, now Q equal to 0, so the transistor will turn off. Now this transistor becomes turn off. As it becomes turn off, now the capacitor C1 charges to the resistor R1. Okay, so the capacitor charges through the resistor R1 and it becomes increases, and after some time it becomes greater than 2/3 VCC. Okay, as capacitor voltage becomes more, it becomes greater than 2/3 VCC. So when we release the switch, this voltage, okay, this voltage becomes again high and it becomes again 0 when we release the switch. Okay, here when we release the switch, then it becomes again 0. So it is high and 0. So it is in no change condition, S0, R0. Okay, so what happens as the capacitor voltage becomes greater than 2/3 VCC? Okay, it becomes greater now. So greater means S becomes 1 and R becomes 0. So as it becomes greater than 2/3 VCC, the flip-flop goes into reset condition. Sorry, it goes into again set condition. Okay, So as flip-flop goes into set condition, so here when it crosses it goes into reset condition. Now when it crosses, it becomes two-third VCC, it becomes again into set condition. So here its Q bar again becomes to zero as it crosses the two-third VCC. So flip-flop again becomes set condition. Okay, when crosses two-third VCC, it becomes set condition. Then what changes will happen here now? As it is sets, means set means what? So here set means Q bar equal to, so 0 and Q equal to 1. Okay, as Q equal to 1, it again turns on. As it again turns on, now this charged capacitor now discharges through the transistor. Okay, so capacitor discharges through the transistor. Okay, as it discharges through the transistor, when it becomes less than 2/3 VCC, flip-flop remains in a no change condition. You know that. So here condition. So here, if capacitor voltage becomes greater than 2/3 VCC, the flip-flop set. If capacitor voltage is less than 2/3 VCC, there is no change. If capacitor voltage becomes less than 1/3 VCC, it goes into reset. So here, flip-flop capacitor voltage becomes greater than 1/3 VCC, it goes into set condition. Set condition means this Q bar output becomes again 0. Okay, Q becomes 1 and capacitor discharges through the transistor. So now this remains forever in this state. To change the state, again we need to apply a trigger. Trigger means just you have to press the switch, the output changes, the trigger voltage changes, becomes less than 1/3 VCC. As the trigger voltage becomes less than 1/3 VCC, it triggers the flip-flop to in reset condition. Okay, when it goes into reset condition, the Q bar output becomes 1, our capacitor charges. As capacitor charges and becomes greater than 2/3 VCC, okay, now what happens? The flip-flop goes into set condition and then its output Q bar return to 0. Set means Q bar 0 and Q equal to 1. You will net set condition means Q equal to 1. Set condition means Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. You know that. So reset condition equal to, that is Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. So here is the flip-flop goes into reset condition. So Q bar equal to 1, here is set, here is set. So when the capacitor voltage crosses the 2/3 VCC, it goes into set condition. When trigger voltage becomes less than 1/3 VCC, flip-flop becomes reset. Okay, when it becomes greater than 2/3 VCC, it becomes set. So here is a separate trigger voltage. So in this, the capacitor voltage is compared with 1/3 and 2/3 in a stable multivibrator. But here, the trigger voltage, when becomes less than 1/3 VCC, the flip-flop goes into reset condition. So how you are going to write this? So just see here, how we are going to write. If we press the switch, okay, that means trigger. So pin number 2 becomes less than 1/3 VCC. This happens when you press the switch. Okay, as the pin number 2 becomes less than 1/3 VCC, second what happens? Okay, so 1/3 VCC, the flip-flop goes into reset condition. Okay, so flip-flop goes into here, written here reset condition. Okay, flip-flop resets. Flip-flop reset means Q bar becomes equal to 1, okay, and Q equal to 0. So here as Q equal to 0, the cup transistor is in off condition. So third one, transistor T turns off. As transistor T turns off, now capacitor charges through R1. Okay, so the capacitor charges now through R1. Okay, so when capacitor charges, it remains in a reset condition. Okay, then fourth step, what happens? As VC, capacitor voltage, becomes greater than 2/3 VCC, flop goes to set condition. Okay, flip flop goes to set condition. Directly you are right, don't go for the comparator. Upper comparator becomes 1 and lower comparator becomes 0. Don't write this, just goes into set condition. So just write here. Okay, so flip-flop goes into set condition, so output Q bar becomes 0 and Q becomes equal to 1. Okay, so again the transistor turns on and capacitor discharges. Okay, so capacitor discharges, transistor turns on and capacitor discharges. So this is a stable state which remains forever until you apply a trigger pulse. Okay, trigger pulse means just you have to press the switch. Okay, transistor on, capacitor discharges. Okay, so as capacitor discharges, last point is VC voltage becomes less than 2/3 VCC. VC voltage becomes less than 2/3 VCC and flip-flop is in no change state again. Okay, so this trigger voltage, so press the switch. Okay, so this will be happen when the pin number becomes less than 1/3 VCC. So after some time, what happens? You release the switch. Okay, you just release the switch and again pin number 2 becomes greater than 2/3 VCC. And what happens when again it becomes greater than 2/3 VCC? Flip-flop is in no change condition now. No change means this condition, reset condition. Okay, as you release the switch again, it does the whatever the sufficient change in the output. Okay, and again if you release it, it remains in the reset, that is no change condition. Okay, so this is the, when we press the switch, it becomes less than 1/3 VCC, it makes the changes in the output, and again if you release it, it remains in the no change condition, that is this. Okay, now capacitor charges, it traverses 2/3 VCC, it changes the state again. Okay, so this is the working of the monostable multivibrator in the point. So this is the initial condition and this is the working. Okay, so it is working, so we can write here also. Okay, so this is the points for the working. Okay. so you can write here now. So okay, so let us stop here now. So this is the another application monostable. So 1 point is remaining here. So this capacitor charges from zero to maximum, and this is the time. Okay, so this is the pulse width, Cauchy stable time. This is the cause. How we are going to calculate this time now? Because the capacitor is charges to the resistor R1, so this time T is calculated by R1 into C1. Okay, so this is the charging time, but there is very small, because capacitor is not going to fully charge, so there is small correction. So time t is equal to 1.1 into R1 into C1. So this is the time. That means you can change this Cauchy stable time by changing the value of R1 and C1. Okay, so by changing the value of R1 and C1, you can change this time. Okay, so this is the working. So let us stop here now.